Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I want to show you how you could scan in documents or even whiteboards using either an iPhone or an Android phone entirely for free. And before we jump into this, as full disclosure, I work at Microsoft as a full-time employee. My HR department requires me to say this because I'm going to be talking about a Microsoft product today. Now you might be wondering, well, hey, I could just use the camera app on my phone to take a picture of the document and that works fine. For example, here I am on my iPhone and I have this document and I could go ahead and let's take a quick picture of it. The thing though is it's not the best quality for a scan, and there are some apps out there that can take much better photos of documents. And today I want to show you one of them called the Office app made by Microsoft. Now this app will work on either an Android phone or an iPhone. Today I have an iPhone, so I'm going to show you how to do it on an iPhone. However, the Android interface is almost identical to the iPhone's interface, so even if you have an Android phone, you'll be able to follow along. So how do we do this? Well, the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to get the app. And to do that on an iPhone, you go to the App Store. On Android, you go to the Play Store. And I'm going to go ahead and click into the App Store. Next, I'm going to go ahead and type in Microsoft Office, and there it is. I'll go ahead and search for it. And you'll see that the top listing here is Microsoft Office. Now, if you don't yet have the app on your phone, you could go ahead and click on install. It doesn't cost anything. It's a free app to put on your phone. In my case, I've already put the app on my phone, so I'm just going to go ahead and open it. So I'm going to click on open, and this will open up the Office app. Now, with the Office app, what you can do is it does a lot more than just scanning documents. You could also create Word, Excel, PowerPoint documents. You could get back to all your content. You could, you know, create Word documents directly from your phone. So there's a lot more you can do than just scanning documents. But in this case, I want to show you how to create a great scan. So what I do is on this main interface, you see three buttons at the bottom. What we're going to do is we're going to click on the one with the big plus icon. And then three different things will pop up. One is Notes, one is Lens, and one is Documents. Now, Microsoft has another app called the Office Lens app. And the Office Lens app is amazing at taking photos of documents or whiteboards, and it cleans them up very nicely. And what Microsoft has done is they've integrated that functionality into the Office app. So you have all that same functionality from Lens directly here. And plus you get a lot of other really nice and awesome functionality. So what I want to do is I want to scan this document. So I'm going to click on Lens, and that'll bring up the Microsoft Lens app. And so here's that same document that I had before. And now I'm going to just kind of hover over it. And here on the bottom, I have three options. One is document, one is photo, and one is whiteboard. Well, in this case, I'm scanning in a document. So I'm going to go ahead and click on document and let's take a picture of it. As I'm doing that, you'll notice that it puts borders around the document. So it's identifying the edges of the document. And look at this nice scan. So what it does is it automatically adjusts the document so it looks like you're looking straight down at the document. And what I could do then is there's this little icon at the base of the document that says filters. I'm going to click on that. And then within filters, what you could do is I could apply different filters to the document. So here I could do black and white. Here's another option with black and white where you see a little bit of the paper. And then here's just purely grayscale. I really like black and white one the most. It gets rid of all the kind of paper background, and it's a really clean scan of this document. And what I can also do is I could also shift the mode after the fact. If let's say I select a document, but it was really a whiteboard, or maybe it was a photo that I wanted to do, but that all looks good. I'm satisfied with that filter. What I can also do is for scanning this document, you'll see an option down here that says file type. So I could click on file type, and here it's now set to Word. I could click on it again and it'll change it to an image file type, or I could click on it again and set it to a PDF. I could choose what type of file I want to save it as. And what I could also do, the add new button in the bottom left-hand corner. Let's say that there are more documents as part of the set that I want to scan. I could click on that and then add another, say, image to that PDF file that I'm creating. All in all, some of the other things I could do, up at the top, I could crop the page more, I could rotate it, I could type text on there. I could also annotate it. Annotating is kind of neat, where here I could go over and, you know, maybe I could draw on the image, or if I want to highlight something, I could do that with the annotation tools. And what I'm going to do next now is I'm going to click on done. And once I click on done, there's my scan. I could once again annotate it. But here in the bottom right-hand corner, there's a share icon. And so I could click on there. And what I could do is I could name the file. I could choose where I want to save it. So in terms of locations, here I could just save it to OneDrive. I could choose the file or the folder location within OneDrive of where I want to save that file. And then I could upload it to the cloud. But let's say I don't want to put it on OneDrive. What I could also do is there's something that says send a copy. And if I click on that, that'll bring up this send a copy dialog. And then I have all my typical either Android or iPhone sharing capabilities where I can email it, I can message it. And you know, however I want to share that file, I could go ahead and do that from here. So I'm gonna go ahead, let's go ahead and upload this file. So I clicked on upload. It looks like it's going ahead and uploading that file now. But what it's done is it's scanned a very high quality copy of this document. And now I could either access it on my phone, I could access it on my PC, wherever I wanna get back to that file. Anyway, hopefully this video helped show you how you could scan very high quality files using either your iPhone or your Android phone. And it's entirely for free for this awesome functionality. I love it. Anytime I get documents in the mail now and I don't want to keep a hard copy, I just scan them in, put them in the cloud, then I don't have to worry about it. Keeps things a lot cleaner too. If you want to see future videos like this, please hit that subscribe button. And lastly, if you want to see, if you have any other ideas or any other videos that you want to see me create, leave a comment down below. I read them all and I'll add it to my list of videos to create. All right, well, that's all I had for you today. Hope to see you next time. Bye.